Hello, welcome to part two of this complete walkthrough of the new PlayStation Network game Journey from Click to Unlock. I'm Escher, and here we have the beginning of the second level, or really the first real level of the game after the sort of introduction level. This one gives you your first real kind of challenge and teaches you a little bit of the world and what kind of to expect as you go forward. So first of all, the first thing I notice is just in the distance there, you might be able to see it just as I'm moving around. There's another one of our little symbols that makes your scarf a bit longer and gives you the ability to jump and fly a bit longer. I would totally recommend collecting these before doing much else, because they just generally make life a lot easier and the game more pleasant and enjoyable when flying around, getting around from point to point. But ultimately, the main task of this level is to find, is to go to these big sort of flag, these metal containers with the flags sticking out at the top of them, and you go and release your vocal communicational thing, whatever it is, your beep, your beacon, your calling, and once you open them up, if I was to do it properly, that is, here we go, we'll try for a second time, there we go. And yeah, once you've done it, it sort of sets off this reaction, opens up the containers, and out flies all these bits of material, which then fly up in this lovely majestic way to the broken bridge and form these beautiful bridge, repairs the bridge in a way, with the lovely magical stuff. When you're down in that one there, up in the top here, there's another one of these little symbols hidden up. I thought I'd just include that to show you because it's handy. But that's why you're near that one, over on this kind of side. Then simply moving around the level, all you do is go to the bigger ones. There's loads of these metal containers around the level. The majority of them are just smaller ones with small amounts of the material in them to just give you sort of power up your scarf. But there's three main ones. There's one on one side, and there's one on the other side, which is this one now. This will make the middle part of the bridge. The one on the left-hand side, as you come out of the entrance, does the last part of the bridge, and this one here on the right-hand side, as you can see, does the second part of the bridge, which you need to complete. Towards the other side and right-hand side, you have this other metal container here with a smaller one, which releases the small bits of material, but a bit more than usual. And as you might have seen there, there's a sand snowfall there, sort of thing, or waterfall rather, snowfall. And another one of the historical wall tablet things, all scattered about, but that's where one of them is hidden. Again, there's a complete guide to where all of these are elsewhere on the channel. But not only that, if you go back out and open up that box outside, you can see there's another symbol on top of the sand waterfall, as it were, the sandfall, and you can get that as well. So there's another three symbols to get on this level, as I said, the majority of them that you can get, the better. It just allows you to fly around the level a lot easier and a lot simpler. And then finally, well, I mean, this is the one that most people would do first. I'm doing it in the reverse kind of order. But this part, it opens up the beginning of the bridge and completes the bridge in order for you to get through the level. Now, there is a trophy for doing this part without completing the entire bridge. That has been done. If you want to know how to do that, you can go and check out the other videos on the channel. And then simply, once you've completed the bridge, you can sit back and marvel at your work, as it were. And then simply, easy enough, just go and enjoy yourself and have a nice little fly up the bridge.
The bridge cloth as well, it powers up your scarf as well, the same as the small bits of cloth.
So when you're on the bridge parts, you can fly and glide up the bridge as well, and that's lovely. And this is the same for any bits of cloth that you find in the game. They all power up your scarf and give you that little extra oomph to be able to go a bit further. And here we have the end of the level plinth, as you can see, all the three. But if you notice as well on the plinth that there's three sort of symbol lights, that denotes how many symbols there were in this level. And if they're all alight, then you got them all. And if you didn't, then you didn't. So, but there is a complete guide to get all of the bits elsewhere on the channel. So, hope you join us for part 3 of the walkthrough.